We're spiritual beings. We are not human beings on a spiritual journey. We're spiritual beings on a human journey. This is the catch 22 that you have to understand and be aware of. And all the time while you do something, it's recorded for eternity. Anything you do is recorded. It's just like they recorded with cameras out there. It's recorded from your ethereal body. Everything that goes on in your life is recorded. There's no running away from anything. You will be confronted with anything you did once you drop this flesh reality. Once you move out of the body, you will see the truth. But then you cannot communicate it back anymore because you have no more larynx to speak. You're going to be silenced. But you know, but you can't do anything with the knowledge that you have because you didn't use it while you were in the flesh body. So it's very important to be clear about what decisions you do, what aims, what is motivating you to do a certain decision. Is it the money? Is it the money or is it the heart that is making the decision? This is the key thing you have to all question yourself. Because if you make the decision for the money, you're going to lose. Because that falls by the wayside. That has no life eternal. If you make the decision for the heart, that has eternal life. That means you take that with you wherever you're going. Your consciousness, you cannot buy. You cannot go in a store and say like, hey, can I have a pint of consciousness or something? Ain't working that way. You have to spend the time to develop it. So if you're busy running around to make money or running faster to make more money, you're losing. You're losing on the long run because you're running yourself in the ground, not developing consciousness. This time is critical. We need to use this time because before too long it's up. And we didn't use the time that was given to us to develop this light being that we are. But we have to consciously do that. It's not going to come to us like a kiss from an angel and like boom, you're illuminating it. It's not going to happen like that. We have to work at it. And this work is like a lot of concentration exercises. Meditation is one of the key things. Yoga is a good thing. Those are all paths that lead to it. But remember, it's all in the heart. If it's not in the heart, it's nowhere. Only the heart energy lives on beyond death. Flesh energy stays all behind, has no life eternal in it. So become aware of that. Now, when you're drinking this green juice, you will feel a connection with the universe. You will feel that you are a universal being on a physical journey. But as long as you don't drink that, you have no clue. You will not know what it's like. And it takes, of course, a little time to come to that understanding and experience. But it will happen. Because it's happening to me and it will happen to anybody else who is willing to go and test it for themselves. Because as I said, there's nothing to lose. You can only win. It's about creating win-win situations anyway. It's not he's better than me or he's better than him. No, it's about like we all want to create something beautiful together. We all have an idea, a vision of what paradise or like a paradisiac society should be like. But it's not manifested in the flesh. We don't see it reflected. We can think it. We can maybe dream it. We get movie scenes that are projecting something like that. But it's not the reality. The reality is when you go out on the street, it's pretty heavy stuff that's going on out there. So the only place you have is like when you withdraw in your own inner sanctuary and you connect with your inner essence, the reason why you chose to be in this flesh manifestation. Because this is just one life of many lives we lived over thousands of years. Just one. There's many lives in you, and it's all condensed into light matter. It's all compressed. Every life that you lived is compressed, like the tree. When you cut the tree, right, you see the rings right there? Every ring is a lifetime. That's how your soul is built too. Lifetime, lifetime, lifetime. The more consciousness you develop in one lifetime, the more light you can generate, the more you can reflect back that cosmic energy that's coming down all the time. It's coming from there. It's not coming from here. Anything that's generated from here, like what the banksters are trying to tell us, that's programming in their favor. That's not programming in connection with the universe and what the universe is really trying to do here. Okay? So forget about the banksters. Understand, they want us as slaves because then they have a comfortable living. Because somebody is like running like the rabbit, right? On the wheel and just like keeps running after the wheel with the carrot that they're dangling in front of you. Guess what? You'll never get the carrot. That's just like an illusion that they carry to keep you running. It's not. Stop running and smell the roses. And all of a sudden you go like, oh my God, I never realized that the carrot is impossible to grab. But you were still running trying to get it. You'll never get it. Impossible. Okay? So this illusion of the carrot can be a Rolls Royce, can be a house, can be whatever you want it to be. It's something material, physical, that will pass with you passing. It has no eternal value. So strive for things that have an eternal essence in them. Something that you can take with you when you leave this body. Your consciousness. See, what makes the difference between a regular person and an ascended master? They took the consciousness with them when they left the body behind, because they had empowered that higher self part in them so strongly that they knew they were just now like taking off, like you're sitting in an airplane and you're taking off. You know you're kissing goodbye to the earth because you're going up into space and you don't know, maybe 10 kilometers, 20 kilometers. There's no guarantee that you're going to come back down. Something might happen and you never come down. So every time you go on an airplane, you take off. Just make sure that you're happy with your life that you created, because you never might come back down, you see? So that's the whole story. When you die, you're not coming back down anymore. When you go to sleep at night, you come back down. You're leaving at night too. You're not in that body that's on the bed. No way! That body is with the light copy of it, is laying in the bed to recharge, but with the cosmic energy that your eye and your astral body are bringing back in the next morning when you wake up. We are cosmic beings. We have to understand that. We are infinite beings. We have no boundaries. The boundaries are set by society, by outside world, people who are like educating us, programming us. When you were born, when you were 5 years old, you had it all figured out. And then they sent you to school, and what? They took that whole thing that you had figured out and made it invalid and said, well, this is what matters. And they told you all the stuff that's useless, okay? If I look back at school, I never learned anything worthwhile. It was all useless information that you can't really like apply in everyday living. See, the real thing nobody ever taught you. That's why people like me have to come and bring your awareness to that, what's really going on. And what's really going on is you can't buy with money. You can't buy love, you can't buy consciousness, you can't buy smiles, you can't do any of that. You can't buy friends. If you think you can buy a friend, wake up because you don't have money anymore, you have no more friends. That's how easy it is. So let's get real, and the one thing we need to do is we need to empower each other. That means a place like this, in spiral, is a beautiful place for these souls to come together and meet and make connections. And because we got to create groups. Only as a group we are strong. Individuals are weak. They can come and get any individuals. If there's a group energy, it's invincible. I mean, look at the Beatles, right? What made the Beatles so special? There were three people in total spiritual synchronicity, and it generated a magnificent wave. It's a spiritual wave. So that, what came then, is going to come now as a tsunami back, okay? Because its time comes in cycles, okay? So it was started and pushed into action in the 60s. It's going to come back now as a major, major wave that is unstoppable. And you know why it is unstoppable? I'll tell you why. For the last 2,000 years, we have been spinning clockwise, spinning clockwise, spinning clockwise. Now we're reaching the zero point, and the Earth is going to turn around, and it's going to go counterclockwise for the next 2,000 years. In fact, that has already been initiated 12 years ago. The Kundalini of the Earth is a reflection of our Kundalini in the body, right? The same energy that we have in the body that can bring us up to enlightenment, the same energy the planet has. Now the planet, in its infinite wisdom, decided that the Himalaya mountains were not a safe place anymore after 6,000 years nestled there as the spiritual center of human evolution, consciousness evolution, and was moved to the Andes mountains at the end of the last millennium. So since 12 years, there's a new energy vortex already starting to spin and spin stronger every day, and it runs counterclockwise. The energy that whatever you see has been built off is gone. All you see is the carcass of it, all the buildings, everything that stands. But behind it is no more energy. It's gone. It was used to build it. Now it's gone. Now it runs counterclockwise. So that's why this whole thing cannot continue like this, because the counterclockwise energy is gathering momentum. And why is it gathering momentum? Because we're at the beginning of a new age. It's the age of Aquarius. It's the age of light, the age of wisdom. We're in it, folks. Wake up. I mean, like, the age of Pisces is done. It's cooked. It's past. It's done. There's nothing in it anymore. Let go of it. Look forward. We got to look forward 1,000 years forward, because we're rolling out a whole new carpet forward. That thing is done. I mean, like, any energy you spend on that is like you're just supporting an old paradigm that's dead anyway. So don't give it any more energy. Wake up and smell the roses and look forward and say, like, where am I going? What am I doing with my life? You all have to ask this question yourself, really, seriously. What are you doing with your life? Are you fulfilling your inner vision, serving your higher self? Or are you serving some kind of like a entity that you can't even understand that works through banksters and governments and all of this other blah, blah, blah? That's fake. It's not real. It appears to be real, but it's not real. Because the moment it dies, there's no life in it. It cannot continue like that. So that has run its course, but we're caught up in it. Everybody who eats cooked foods is definitely caught up in that old paradigm. That's for sure. Okay, I've been 20 years on live foods. I don't eat anything cooked. I don't even touch any of that stuff. It's all garbage. It doesn't have no information. It's just sludge that I would put into my body. I don't need sludge in my body. I want life force, light force, energy. Okay, and this is what you only can get on living foods. And you have understanding, consciousness, new thoughts are coming. When you start eating, anybody that I know that had never had living foods and starts eating living foods, after, I promise you, 3 weeks, you get a whole new ideas. Like whole new, like, wow, wow, all these new thoughts come because finally they can come in. Before they couldn't because you were blocking them eating cooked foods. There's no information in cooked foods. It's cooked out of it. It's done, okay? So get that straight. Right? And this is a good place for you guys to meet and come together, and I'm so grateful that they're allowing stuff like this, like, you know, to come out. Because otherwise, if you're following the newspapers, I'm telling you, you're not getting anything but ripped off every time you read that stuff, because your consciousness is going to be brought straight back into the same paradise that enslaved you from the first time that you went to school and they laid all these programs into you. So we have to deprogram ourselves, get out of that. How do you do it? Green juices, living foods. It's the fastest way to deprogram yourself because that's new information. You never had that before. Your body is recognizing it though right away because your body is more than just a flesh entity. It's a spiritual being. It has a soul and it has a spirit. There's three dimensions going on every moment of your life. But anything, consciousness, love, good deeds, visions, all of that, the angel can work with that and can communicate that and then connect you. You can actually get connected while you're sleeping because your angel is connecting you with what you need. Because whatever you need will be given unto you. That's how it's written in the scriptures. So that's why I say there's nothing to lose. Don't worry. If you're worrying about something, then you're not tied into the moment. Because if you're in the moment will give the next moment birth, and out of that moment, the next moment. Because the future is not born tomorrow, it's born now. Right here, right now. It's not born tomorrow, now. Now is the future, right here out of this moment. And the last moment is already passed, but I know you remember because chlorophyll is such a powerful reminder that, hey, we're eternal light, and we are this light forever. We just need to empower ourselves. So wake up and focus on your inner vision. Why did we choose to be here? Why did we want to watch this incredible spectacle that's now unfolding outside? A lot of people are sleeping through it. They don't even realize what's really going on because it's going on in the cosmos. It's not going on Earth. That's all deception. All this Hollywood blah, 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 apocalypse and end of the world. That's all cooked food thinking, okay? It's not going to happen like that. Forget it, okay? So you have all been programmed to think Third World War and blah, blah, blah. Don't you think that the angels are smarter than that and gonna not let that happen? It's not gonna happen, okay? Because the moment these guys are ready to push the buttons, they're dead. They have no more life vibration to continue. They can't. The angel will prevent that from happening because we know it's not gonna lead to anything fruitful. We know that from the last world war, it's never gonna bring any happiness or anything positive. It's just gonna bring destruction and hate and more of all this bad energy that we don't need anymore, okay? And this is what's happening. They keep us boxed in with all this fear projection, fear projection. There's nothing to fear if you drink grass juice because you're connected to love and light, you see? But if you eat dead flesh, of course, then you're connected to fear because that animal had to go through fear to become that piece of meat that's now on your plate, okay? And that energy is in there. You can't get it out of there. You're taking that piece of fear into your body by eating it. So this is why this is such a great place. There's none of that garbage happening here, you know? Thank God. Hallelujah. Good. So, we don't need the meat. It's an illusion. There's more protein in grass than in meat. Wake up, okay? There's more protein in blue-green algae. There's more protein in so many other beautiful things than meat, okay? So forget that. That's old paradigm. That's worthless. That's dead. Forget it. Let's look forward. 1,000 years. Where are we going? Where are we going to go? What do we want to create? This is our chance. We came here to create something. This is our chance. But we're not using it because we're like, you know, diverted in our attentions to the movies, to this and that and that. We're always looking outside, outside. The answer is inside. It's not outside. And each of us has the answer for whatever needs to happen to create heaven on earth. Because heaven is already there. We just need to channel and make it happen here on this plane. That's all we need to do. But how are we going to do it? Where is the energy to do it? It's in the chlorophyll, because the chlorophyll builds the bridge to the heavens. That's all there is to it, you know? So all I can ask you is like, start drinking more chlorophyll green juices. Unfortunately, it's November now and the grass is kind of slowing down outside. So that's why for me it's time to move south, you know, where it's warmer climate so I can continue this transformational journey. Because it's about transformation of consciousness, you know? And this is what these other people, these cabal people are trying to prevent from happening, the evolution of consciousness. But as I told you before, they can't, because the universe is changing the energy flow. It's running counterclockwise now. It's running counterclockwise since about 10 years. But now it's gathering momentum, it's getting really strong, and this is why this whole thing is shaking and not holding up anymore. And when you think New York, that was heavy, that wasn't heavy, that was just the opening act. Wait till the next stuff is going to happen. Mother Earth is so powerful, we have no idea. We take it for granted that this thing has been so stable for so long. And we have helped a lot to get it out of balance. So the Earth itself that used to be in a balanced position is totally out of balance. And the Earth is shifting because the spiritual pole has shifted. Now, the physical has to follow by law of nature. It has to, because energy goes where attention flows. Boom. Wherever your attention, that's where the energy goes. Boom. So wherever you put your attention, that's where the energy goes. So be aware where you put the tension. When you put the tension to bad movies that are like full of violence and stuff, you're taking that in unconsciously. You don't register it consciously, but it's in there. You programmed in there into your unconscious. And guess what? 95% of your actions are determined out of your unconscious. Out of your unconscious. There's a guy called Bruce Lipton. Amazing guy. Look him up too. He's amazing what he says. He says like, only 5% of our consciousness is in the now. 95% is all program, like automatic pilot that runs up. You don't even know why you're doing something. You're just doing it because it's an automatic pilot that you're acting upon. Now he says the only time you're not an automatic pilot is when you're in the honeymoon phase, when you're in love. Because why? Then you're creating your reality right there. You're in the moment. You're creating that reality. And it makes total sense. So how do you lose the honeymoon? By falling back into the old programs. And then you're back there. And then the honeymoon is gone. And then the magic is gone. And then you think you need a new love because you need a new honeymoon. No. You just need to work through what you need to work through and come back to the honeymoon state. And that's like being excited about every moment in life. Because that's what it's all about. Any questions at this point in time?
What's the name of the author you just
did? That was Dr. Bruce Lipton. Like the Lipton tea, just think that's how I locked it in my memory. Lipton tea, Bruce Lipton. You can see him on the internet. It's beautiful, fabulous interviews with him where he's laying this all down. That's where I have the understanding from, you see. It's the same thing with information, right? We have to digest food, right? The same thing is with information. We have to digest information. We have to take knowledge and apply it in life. What is all the knowledge worth if we don't use it? It's worthless. We have to take the knowledge and apply it in living life daily. And this is, what do we do 3 times a day? Most people is eating food. So that's your first easiest way to change anything in your life. Taking a different food energy, a life food energy that actually has information and will bring you new understanding, new awareness. Just by eating that food, you don't even have to do nothing but eating the life food, and it does its job on its own for you, inside of you. And you're just going to be amazed at the new thoughts and the new ideas that are going to be coming up and like, wow, wow, I never thought about this. Wow, wow. And this is how it really works. Because we have been locked in and boxed in into this old paradigm. And that's dumb, as I told you. Yes?
Hi, where can we read more about this kind of eating? Like...
tons of it. I mean, when I started 30 years ago, there was like you had to really find it. Now it's everywhere. You just punch in Google.
Living food.
Living foods, Google. I mean, there's so much information out there now on it.
Is there something like you recommend? Because there are a lot of, you know, entities to this knowledge as well. So I want to...
I agree. I'd say as like a good start, like on the whole living foods, is Dr. Gabriel Cousins. I think he's Dr. Gabriel Cousins. I think he's a good one who has like some real serious knowledge. You see on that? I mean, even David Wolf is really good for what he's doing, but he's too much into the chocolate. The chocolate is not going to get you there, okay? The chocolate is just another drug like alcohol. It's going to keep you wherever, and it's going to give you some nice, warm experiences, but it's not going to give you consciousness, okay? And all the stuff that they talk about, what all great ingredients are in there, fine, okay? I just know, like, if I eat too much of it, I get really tired, and it's not going to help me in any which way. But if I drink a lot of green juice, I'm never tired. I always have tons of energy. So the key is the greens. You know, the greens are the healers. This is what you have to write on as a mantra on your refrigerator. The greens are the healer. There's nothing else that can bring healing but the greens and your body itself. That's why they invented fasting. Okay, what is fasting other than stopping the supply of solid food short? You don't eat anything anymore. You don't digest anything anymore. Guess what? Most people spend 60% of their daily energy on digesting food, okay? So if you go to juices, you go directly to the energy. You don't need to digest the energy. It goes right into you. You have it right away at your behest. Boom. Within 15 minutes, I drink that green juice and like, yeah, whoa, we're ready. Rocket fuel kicked in, okay? This is how it really happens. But, you know, you have to build up that tolerance for that. I don't recommend anybody starts drinking a liter of green juice because it's gonna be like overkill. It's too much. The body's not used to it. It's too toxic. You have to go slow about it. So fasting is a good way to just like ease the old stuff out and then add in more of the good stuff. Add in more of the real thing. And just like, and that will cut the desire for the bad stuff because the body knows what's good for it. It will recognize, it'll play with you if you give it the righteous energy and the righteous fuel. But the key thing is, when you go into a fast, you're basically allowing your body to use those 60% of energy instead of digesting food to go into repair mode. That means attack anything. If you have a cancer cell growing, if you have a tumor growing in your body, if anything is not right, you stop eating and you keep doing that liquid for a while, you'll see like how the body's like, wow, you get like your senses get sharper, your eyes get more, you hear better. Everything gets overhauled. The body is an amazing thing. It is the ultimate doctor. But you got to give it the chance to do its healing. See, so with the green juice, it's a good way to bring the healing without having to fast much. You know, you can still eat food, but choose living foods. Don't choose anything cooked. But the vibration comes up with the green juice. Because we're vibrational energy beings, you know. We are radiating energy. Anybody who has bad thoughts, it radiates out of them. You can pick up on that if you're sensitive enough. If you're not sensitive enough, you cannot pick anything up because you're just like not in tune with what's really going on. In order to be in tune with what's really going on, you have to tune yourself up. And to tune yourself up means like to get rid of a bunch of stuff that's sitting in your system. For example, a colonic. Who knows what a colonic is? Okay. Basically, to make it for layman's words, it's an internal water massage of your colon, right? Basically, you put a bunch of like beautiful water in there and you take all this old mess that's in there and not coming out by itself anymore. You take it out. You just flush it out. And like, wow, is that a relief? You feel just like amazing after that stuff. Because imagine, all of a sudden, all this garbage that had been sitting in there for all this time is removed. And all of a sudden, like your body is like, you know, instead of driving with your handbrake on and wondering why you're not getting more momentum, boom, put the handbrake out and boom, you're rolling, you know. And this is what this stuff is inside of that, your intestines, you know. It's like extra waste that is not coming out because it's been white bread, cheese, gooey stuff that's stuck to the walls. So it can't come out. But when you put the water in, you flush it against its stream and it loosens up and then the water carries it out. So I can recommend to anybody to have a higher life experience, do at least a colonic a year, better twice in the spring and in the fall, and you will notice how your energy surge, how you're like, wow, you have so much more power, so much more energy. Because it's not the food that gives you the energy, it's the spiritual that gives you the energy. I'm driven by spiritual energy. Yeah, food is there, but it's the spiritual energy that I tap into and that I can channel and download from the higher planes down to the physical plane because it's coming from there. I'm not taking it from here, I'm taking it from there and reflecting it back to you over there.